This is the first time any private organization has built border wall on private land, and it's happening right here in the El Paso area. Get this, the Army Corps of Engineers said that piece of land is too rugged to build on. You can't build there. Well, we build the wall, prove them wrong, and the wall has been going up over the weekend. We've been building, we're working 24/7 over the holiday weekend to give America a present on this Memorial Day.
That was former Kansas Secretary of State Kris Kobach talking about private industry stepping in where the government, at least so far, couldn't. The group We Build the Wall built fencing outside of El Paso, and they say they did it faster and cheaper than the government could. So far, the group has raised over $22 million on GoFundMe, and yesterday, the group completed half a mile of an 18-foot-high steel bollard wall. They say the new section fills in a gap on the U.S.-Mexico border. So is this another example of what private industry could and should do rather than the government?
Absolutely not. This might be something where the private industry is showing they can do things better than the government, which I don't think is anybody's surprise. But if you're built half a mile of that wall, you still have 1,953 and a half miles left to build on the Mexican border. Look, this is ridiculous that we've gotten to this point that citizens feel like they either have to form a militia, build a wall or something for their own safety or whatever it is they're building it for. We still have, even if you build a wall, parts of the, you cannot build a wall. Army Corps of Engineers are correct about that. You still have 860,000 people right now backed up in amnesty cases. Yeah. You still have 11 to 12 million people in this country illegally we have to deal with. A wall is certainly part of it, but it shouldn't be citizens building that. We need comprehensive immigration reform, which no one is proposing right now. And it's shameful on our government that we don't have that.
Yeah, which shows that here you've got the private sector overlooking that and putting up a wall that could be, you know, the quality could be compromised. This wall was, the money came from a GoFundMe page, like we heard in the intro. It's been started since December. They've averaged about $67 per donation to the tune of about $22 million. They've only put up about half a mile, but they're saying, hey, it's cheaper. It costs us about $6 million to put up. But the main contractor, that's what I'm concerned about. The main contractor is Fisher Industries. I don't know if that sounds familiar because that's what the president has pushed forward in the past to become the main contractor for this wall. So this could be a publicity stunt for this company to show, hey, look how fast we did it. Look how quickly we could put up half a mile. Why don't you give us the contract for the full border?
It feels like a bad use of money. So if you are trying to raise $1 billion and you raise $22 million, you are still $978 million short from what your goal was. Not really sure why Kris Kobach thinks that this was even worth starting when you are nowhere near your goal. I actually think they should give back the $22 million.
Oh, God. Everybody here hates the entrepreneurial spirit.
No.
I think that this is amazing.
No.
People came together. They raised money. Volunteers went out. And they showed that something could get done more effectively, more efficiently, more quickly. I think this is fantastic. And maybe this puts pressure on the government to get its act together and to do immigration reform. And if not, it gives us another solution. Because at the end of the day, the government is always ineffective. They're always inefficient. And they always do a bad job.
Carol, but a half a mile of wall, honestly, a half a mile of wall is not going. I know,
Robert,
it's not going to build.
It's a proof of concept, right?
Yeah.
It's a proof of concept. If you got Donald Trump on Twitter asking for the donations to GoFundMe, you don't think that we could raise more than $22 million and do a substantial portion?
My guess is there's a...
So what's next, a militia?
Right, I don't understand.
And let them defend the country?
I'm only responding to you think this half mile will bring immigration reform. That's just not happening.
Well, hold on a second,
half
because there is
not
one group besides Carol and myself, by the way, who approve of this. I'm for everybody taking a part in this. But you know who else approves of it? Is the Border Patrol agents. The Border Patrol agents, one like anybody here, puts their lives on the line every single day protecting our border and trying to make some sense out of this mess that is the border. And I would think, John, for example, that you, being a Texan, would appreciate that.
I appreciate the fact that our border agents are doing a wonderful job,
yeah.
And I think they should be saluted for the job they are doing. And I think their thing in this, I can't read their minds, is that they want awareness raised for what the issue is going on, because they are saying, 100% of them are saying this is a crisis that's going on the border.
Absolutely.
I just don't think the citizens should be the ones building walls. I don't think citizens should be armed and defending our border as militias either.
Mm.
I think the government has a role to do this, and if the border agents are saying they like this, they like it because awareness is being raised.
Participating in that role, John. I mean, that's the point. What if they're not able to participate, either because of a judge or because of, you know, Democratic squabbling or whatever?
But what's the answer, David? I mean, you're going to have citizens
build the
entire
wall? Well, this might be the answer. Well, who knows? At least it's a start. At least, I know it's a long way to go, and Robert is absolutely right. I mean, it's a ridiculously small part of what has to be done. On the other hand, somebody's doing something, and I think that should be appreciated.
But would you agree that citizens arming themselves is incorrect? Because you have citizens
that's a separate,
down there right
that's
now
a separate
themselves.
That's a separate issue.
But
this is a wall. To
John's point, he might be thinking a little bit long term. This is the beginning step. You have civilians building a wall. What's next? And then they're going to start protecting. Are they going to become contractors that eventually will start to pay out?
It's on
as
private property, and people are protecting their own property.
We don't know.
I'm in favor of our ability as citizens to do that.
These are people taking action and putting their money where their mouth is. We have so many people who are always spewing rhetoric. This is somebody taking action. We should applaud people taking action. It doesn't absolve our government for the responsibility for doing something. But if they don't do something, I am proud that fellow Americans have gone out and done this. I think
it's
fantastic.
And it's better than the squawking between politicians. I'm so sick of that. I just want to close my ears to all that noise.